I heard something that somebody on the gun shop called up the state police and asked questions, and they told him something. Then he called back to have it clarified, and they told him something different. And the third time he called, they told him something totally different.
Guilty. That was me. I called the state police, and my first question, I had several questions. I've called them and written down, documented every time I've called them. But the state police are doing a good job. They're trying to give out information, but the law is so convoluted and so vague that they can't be positive unless they check with their legal department, and the legal department gives them different answers. Because I called first time and I asked a number of questions. One of the questions was, can I sell a strip lower receiver for an AR? And I was told, yes, you can. There's no features on that. If it's just a strip lower, there are none of the offending features and you can sell that. I wasn't satisfied with that. I called them back for other questions about a week later. And I asked, again, let me just verify, can I sell a strip lower receiver? The young lady I talked to said, absolutely not. I said, why? She said, because, I said, it doesn't have any of the features. She said, well, it's capable of taking a pistol grip. I said, I don't have one. You could buy one, she said. I said, so the capability of taking...
The capability of committing a crime.
The capability of taking a pistol grip means I can't sell this. Yes, that's true. We checked with our legal department. Okay, I got off the phone now thinking I can't sell them. 2 weeks later, I called them over some other questions. I said, let me just verify one more time because I got two different answers. Can I sell a strip lower receiver? The nice gentleman said, let me go check with the head investigator. And he came back and said, Mr. So, he actually gave me the head investigator to come to think, remember it. And that gentleman told me, yes, you can sell lower receivers. They have none of the features as long as you don't have a pistol grip to put on that protrudes. And I got three different answers. Now, a few different times we were contradicted.
Oh my goodness.
But that's an example of what we're getting. And it's honestly because they don't know, and because the law is so complex, they have to go to their legal department and re-ask the question. And it's just like calling the IRS three different times.
I've had problems with the IRS too.
How much you owe,
and
you get three different answers.
Right. Yes. Absolutely. And you can go to jail too if you're wrong. It's
and that's basically
or have your business.
And you can hear. And you can hear. If I sell something that I'm not allowed to sell on the word of somebody there, they're not going to take my word for that. I got the wrong answer from them, and that means nothing. And I can end up in trouble, or a citizen can end up in trouble. Someone who has a rifle. A good example was, one of the questions I asked is, can you take a revolver that holds 10 shells and fill the cylinder up and hold 10 shots in it? First answer was, no, you can't, because you're not allowed to have more than 7 in a magazine. We consider the cylinder a magazine. So here I'm telling people, you can't even load your revolver in full if it holds.
You just put 7 bullets in it?
That's what they told me first. Now, I called back later. One of my customers says, let me call and try another couple of days, a week later. And the answer was, no, revolvers are exempted. You can load them right up. So, I mean, we got contradictory answers there. Now, had I used the advice and told somebody you can load your cylinder right up and the other answer was out there, then I'm putting people in jeopardy. So the state police even have trouble answering the questions on this. And when did you see a law pass where the state had to send panels of three to sit down county to county and explain the law and answer questions, and they couldn't even answer the questions that were generated by this law?
So what about if you have a 22 that holds 7 bullets in the clip and there's one in the chamber? Was that considered?
No, that's legal to have one in the chamber, because their restriction was on the magazine, that the magazine holds 7. And what that means is, if you have 7 in the mag, you're legal, and one in the chamber, you're still legal. That's a good question. We get that all the time.
So you got a pistol. In 5 years from now, you got to renew it. Do they send you something in the mail, like your car registration they're trying to compare it to?
Well, there's another part of the fiasco of this bill. You know, they wanted to do a renewal on permits. And they know if they implemented it now, the county clerks all across the state, all 60 counties or so, are going to complain, because they're going to do all this paperwork. So what they did was they put it off for 5 years. They said all permits are renewable in 5 years from now. So what that means is 5 years from now, in 2018, every permit holder across the state, other than people within 5 years, are going to renew all at once. Can you imagine the cost? And if you're worried about taxes, imagine all the extra cost that's going to be involved. It's going to come from somewhere out of taxes that every county clerk has to renew everybody's permit at once.
And the judge has to sign that, so the judges are going
to
be busy.
It all has to go through judges. It all has to be done at once. And that's how the law was written. And that is because they didn't want to scare people. That's why they did the $10 fee for doing the background check person to person, because they wanted to look like heroes. Hello. They wanted to say, it's only going to cost you $10 in a store, knowing full well that the store gets $35 normally to do that service.
So maybe you feel that they're trying to drive people out of business? I mean, gun shops are evil. I've heard that from a politician.
What I think is... I think when the law was proposed, when they felt they had the votes through this Republican-Democrat coalition, when they felt they had the votes, they handed in the anti-gunners wish list, which is what they have had in the works cooking for years and years and years, and they put every aspect of it in they could, along with a couple things to make stiffer penalties so that it would be palatable to some people. But what issue have you ever seen where gun owners were actually allied with physicians, because the doctors are going crazy with the mental health reporting that they have to do for this act, and they're just as upset as gun owners.
What was I heard on that? Like, I think most people would agree that somebody with mental problems perhaps shouldn't own a gun, but I heard something, if you're on a Valium or certain drugs, they nail you. Is that true? Or you're depressed, they can say you can't own a gun?
Part of what they included in the SAFE Act was the type of drug you could be on that would prohibit you from buying, and many of the drugs that are taken for mentally ill people have other uses and are taken by other people for other reasons.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, that labels them as now not allowed to purchase in New York State, and that's not fair, basically. And a lot of the physicians look at it and say, we have to report.
Liability for them. Again.
Well, not just liability, but they have to report by the SAFE Act anybody they feel is could be dangerous to themselves. And what that does for them is it tells them that anybody who is going to get treatment is now going to think twice about getting treatment when they need it, because they don't want their guns taken away on the thought that they might have to get treatment. And so a lot of times people that require treatment will not be getting it, will just skip it, ignore it, don't go to doctors, because they know anything they say is going to be not necessarily confidential like it was with HIPAA. It's going to be spilled to the state police.
Makes me depressed. Oh, I shouldn't have said that.
Yeah. You may not be able to own your guns for long. Watch out.
I'll just keep smiling. Like they do, right? Keep smiling.
We smile through it, but let me tell you something. This is an affront to the honest citizens of New York. And all it is smoke and mirrors. And if people don't realize it, they have to understand one thing. Criminals will not stop getting guns illegally.
Or terrorists.
Background checks will not stop criminals and terrorists from getting in. They'll send someone in to get them. So this is nothing more than a slight delay for the criminal with intent. But what it is 100% inconvenience to honest citizens. And the only people that will comply and will try and do anything is honest citizens. And the people that pass this law know that. They know it will not affect the crime level. They know it will not affect the violence that's associated, because to them, this is a political advancement. This is just a bill they could say they did something so they can move to a better position. Andrew Cuomo would like to be president, and this was his stepping stone to it. Right on us, but it was his stepping stone to it. And unfortunately, I think he's hurt himself with this, because the rest of the country rejected gun control because of what happened to New Yorkers. You know, they see us and say, look at those poor guys in New York, what happened to them? We don't want any part of that. So they made a huge effort to call and influence the Congress and Senate when they look at Obama's gun control.